James Cho and good evening guys. So it's a beautiful Saturday evening out here and me and my friend Omen, we are ready to embark on a gastronomical journey of Gujarati food. And what better way to go on a journey of Gujarati food rather than to have a Gujarati thali. And we are here at Gopi restaurant, none other than Gopi restaurant. It's a fantastic place. What do you think, Omen?
Yes, Gopi has a history as it's one of an institute in as far as food is concerned, as far as Gujarati food is concerned. It's one of an institute that's as old as anything else in Ahmedabad. And obviously its owner, Dilip Bhai, is going to greet us inside and he'll be sharing with us the details and all the fun facts about Gopi and its food. So we are really excited about this. And well, looking forward to this awesome Gujarati gastronomical journey.
Absolutely, and I'm so pleased to come once more to Gopi, because I've been coming here since a long time, since the time that they started out at Ashram Road. I've been their customer and I just love to come to this place and gorge on the delicious Gujarati dishes. So Omen, without wasting any time, let's go inside and get to the business.
Yes, let's take this on the food map of Ahmedabad.
Yep. Thank you so much. Good evening.
Welcome, sir. Welcome.
Good evening. It's a pleasure to be here.
Thank you.
At Gopi once again.
We always love our guests.
Fantastic.
Good evening. Welcome.
So guys, we are inside the restaurant and it's a beautiful ambience, perfect place to have your Gujarati thali. What is it, Omen?
Amazing. I always look forward to eating here. I enjoy it. It's a celebration coming in here. It's not just having a thali, but it's celebrating the thali.
Absolutely.
And Gopi does that brilliantly.
And I'm sure everything from the ambience to the way you are served the food, I think everything counts as an experience, and I have always loved the experience out here. And why don't we meet the owner, the founder of Gopi?
Yes, Dilip Bhai, he is a legend in the hoteling industry across the country, especially in Ahmedabad.
The man of the moment is here, Dilip Bhai Thakkar. He's the founder and the owner of Gopi restaurant, which was founded in the year 1979. And since then, it has been pleasing the taste buds of the food connoisseurs out here in Ahmedabad and has been serving absolutely yummy Gujarati thalis. Dilip Bhai, thank you very much for pleasing us all through the amazing Gujarati thali. Dilip Bhai, why don't you tell us a little bit about your journey?
Gopi Dining Hall was started on 14 February 1979.
Wow, that's my birthday! Fantastic!
That was Valentine's Day.
Valentine's Day.
But my father never knew it was a Vasant Panchmi as per Gujarati Titi.
Oh.
That is how it was started on the 14th February.
Okay.
And since then, it was started in a very humble way. We started with the tables and chairs and vessels on rental and kancha ceiling and all those things. It was my father's passion because he was used to work in this industry as a child. And the location was near VS Hospital. So we started in a humble way and slowly and gradually the more time passed by and we studied, we changed from non-air conditioned to air coolers and then air conditioned. And touch wood, since last 14 years we have been serving consistently with the award-winning performance.
Absolutely, and as they say, the journey, the fantastic journey starts with one single step, and that is how Gopi started its journey, and that is how they have come to this fantastic restaurant, and we are looking forward to having the Gujarati food. So Dilip Bhai, can you tell me a little bit about, because Gujarati thali or Gujarati dishes includes a lot of dishes. Okay, how come you decided on these items, being here on the menu?
My late father Damodar Bhai always told us, my son, never compromise on your ethics and your philosophy of doing business. Gujarati thali is supposed to be a traditional Gujarati thali. It has lot of ingredients. We can serve n number of breads, rice, khichdi, bakri, rotla, thepla, khandvi, dokla. Yeah. So never enter the paneer inside the gopi. No chole, no spring dosa, no Chinese samosa.
Authentic Gujarati cuisine.
Yeah, you have to stick to it. And that is how this is a comprising all things. Then Gujarati thali is a complete thali. Kathol, green sabji, chash, so calcium, protein, everything and everything you expect for one normal human being, you will get it from the thali.
Absolutely, absolutely, and I've always been a fan of it. And you know, looking at the thali, my mouth has started watering. And Oman, why don't we start the food? Or you would like to say something to Mr. Thakkar?
Well, Dinip Bhai is a legend in the industry. He's been serving Ahmedabad, and probably the whole world travelers that come to Ahmedabad are supposed to like and come this place and eat it. So it's one of the authentic Gujarati thali places. And as you see, the spread is wonderful. Like Dilip Bhai said, there is nothing that is even a little bit of fusion. It's all very genuinely Gujarati. And the fact of the matter is, we have heritages from, not from Gujarat, and yet we enjoy this. And it's institutions like this that have fed us, which appeal and spread the joy of food to non-Gujaratis as well.
Yeah,
so it's places like this.
And I would also like to add one more thing. You know, the ambience, perfect, the food, fantastic, but there's one more thing, you know, which enhances the experience at Gopi. Your personal, you look after your customers personally. I have always found that you look after your customers personally, and I think that goes a long, long way in, you know, maintaining your customers and, you know, maintaining the quality of food.
Yeah, Dilip,
fantastic.
Dilip Bhai himself has that experience.
Love it.
And you will be surprised. My father told me that never have your own office. Otherwise, you will never come to the floor, and the moment you leave the floor, your guests will leave you.
No, absolutely. I've seen you always active on the floor along with your staff. You lead from the front.
Thank you, sir.
And that is a fantastic trait, sir. Fantastic trait. So, Oman, after all this, makes me hungry.
Yeah.
Let's attack the food.
Sure.
Please enjoy, sir.
Great.
Thank you so much.
So, guys, our khana serve ho chuka hai. It is a beautiful plate, which I've already photographed with my mobile phone. I always love the way they serve the food and the way it is served. I think, you know, it looks pretty amazing, and I'm ready to dig into the food. So, our food, we start to eat before eating. Oman, would you like to, you know, explain what all the...
You know, did you notice, Abraham, one thing is the beauty of the whole thing is while we were sitting and chatting, just introducing ourselves and Mr. Dilip was there, we never knew how fast the plate was served. And it's all happened right in front of us. So the smoothness in the service,
smoothness.
That's something to enjoy.
Yeah. In fact, it's much better than the other Gujarati dining places, you know, where they literally throw the food.
Yeah. It's a drama unfold.
Yeah.
It's smooth. It's class.
Yeah.
We have a flour, vatana, or tomato ka sabzi hai. Saragwa, which is a drumstick thing. You got a potato. Lentil, basundi. I've chosen dal. Ibrahim has chosen
kadhi.
Traditional. We got a halwa, mung halwa for sweet. We got a malpua. We got roti. We got puri. We got bhakri. We got a khaman. We got a batata wada. We got some salad. We got some chutney. And we got some chaas.
And we got the papad.
Papad and the fried chilies.
Absolutely. So, Oman, bhakri is a part of Gujarati cuisine, or it has come from Rajasthan cuisine?
Bhakri is a Gujarati cuisine. It's one of the many flat Indian breads that are made. What happens with the thing is, there are a lot of breads, that flat breads that are made in India, and bhakri is one of them.
Mm-hmm.
It's quite essential, very Gujarati. Batata vada or potato vada, and well, it looks great.
Awesome.
And didi chutney jo rakha
hua, this is the one that they use in vada pav, right?
Mm. The one thing about a Gujarati thal is there is no beginning and there is no end. You kind of
no end. Absolutely.
Look at what you like.
You can start from anywhere you like.
The dal has a hint of sweet, nice. Mm-hmm. All right. One thing we would like to know from the viewers is, how has your Gujarati thali experience been? And if at all, what is it that you look forward to in a Gujarati thali? I mean, what item on the menu? And if you have a favorite Gujarati place, why you like it?
Absolutely.
Do leave a comment, and we would like to know why, what is liked by so many people.
Absolutely.
Bajri.
See, there's one more flatbread.
Hmm.
Bajri ka rotla. Now, this is a very easy.
Bajre ka rotla, thoda sa ghee. So ye jo hota hai bhaiya,
ये बाजरे का रोटला और घी जो होता है वो बहुत ही बड़े बढ़िया होता है और ये कढ़ी के साथ खाया जाता है। लेट मी, मैं ये खाता हूँ कढ़ी के साथ, गर्मा गर्म बाजरे का रोटला है,
वार्म बाजरे का रोटला सर्व विद घी ऑन टॉप,
स्पेशली इन द विंटर्स। ये विंटर का फूड है बाजरे का रोटला। Malpua kiya try?
And the thing is, I'm gonna dig into the Malpua. Boy, oh boy. That is mouth watering already.
Badhiya. Malpua badhiya.
That is joy.
Very, very nice.
That is joy. So when you see a man licking his fingers after tasting something, trust me, that has done justice to his palate. There is enough is not a word. They keep serving you till you kind of are there getting exhausted eating it.
So Oman, aap you know normally khane ke saath mein aap sweet dishes khate hain ya last mein hi khate hain? But because I prefer to have my sweet dishes along with the food.
That's the joy of thali, like I said. Thali mein aisa nahi ki hum last khate. You kind of mix match. It's a process when you're cleansing your palate.
Absolutely.
And re-digging into each flavor again and again. Yeah. That's fresh.
So आप एक कुछ तीखा खाते हैं, फिर कुछ मीठा खाते हैं, एंड फिर कुछ तीखा खाते हैं। I mean it is a mixture of all the flavors, right?
आपका पैलेट बोर नहीं हो रहा
है। और थाली में वही मजा है।
वही
मजा है।
This one there, we got the regular poppers with the muri and all, but then we got these rice crisps as well. So they are rice poppadoms and they are beautiful.
But मुझे ये यहाँ पे इन्होंने roasted पापड़ दिए हैं और fried पापड़ दिए हैं, rice पापड़ दिए हैं. But मेरा favorite तो ये ही है, which is the fried पापड़, fried rice पापड़. Absolutely.
That crunch is
amazing. Yeah.
That's one thing you notice, a typical Gujarati da with peanuts in there.
Yeah. Mm.
That is a sign of authenticity.
Yeah.
That's very Gujarati. You don't find it happening in any of the other dals served across India. This is what I was talking about. It keeps coming and coming and coming until you say enough is enough.
Maybe I'll take. Yeah. All right. So let's do this one.
Thank you.
So guys, जैसे देखा आप लोगों ने कि food is absolutely unlimited over here. और आप जब तक खा खा के थक नहीं जाते तब तक ये लोग आते रहे होंगे और आपको फूड सर्व करते करते रहेंगे. Fantastic. जब गर्मा गर्म रोटी मिलती है ओमन तो आपका लिमिट पता नहीं चलता आपको, एंड यू जस्ट कीप ऑन ईटिंग अनटिल द टाइम यू आर एब्सोल्युटली फुल. तो लेट मी डिग इनटू द गर्मा गर्म रोटी.
आई एम
एंड दिस टाइम
ट्राई द सरगवा थिंग, द सब्जी विद द ड्रम.
सरगवा हेल्थ के लिए बहुत अच्छा होता है. सरगवा इज अ ड्रम स्टिक. आपने काउंट किया क्या कितनी डिशेस किया सर? That was something interesting.
Well, that's something we're not paid attention to, but I think it will be no less than 20 items on the plate that we've been served today, right from popcorn to chops.
So guys, aapko 20 items milti hai, you know, starting from starters to, you know, desserts in this Gujarati thali. So if you want to experience Gujarati thali, this is it. Fantastic. So guys, we are absolutely, I mean, we are almost getting full, and there's one more my favorite item which has come, which is patatana bhajiya aa gaye hain abhi, aur mirchi ke bhajiya jo aa gaye hain. और दिलीप भाई भी आ गए हैं यहाँ पर हमारे साथ में थोड़ा सा वक्त बिताने के लिए. So, Dilip bhai, एक चीज हम लोग बार बार बात कर रहे हैं, what is the number of items that you serve? हमने count तो किया नहीं, but that is something, एक question है.
We serve minimum 16 to maximum 24 things at a time in the thali.
Okay.
So my guess was right, about 20 something.
What he said was, it is like a whole 7-course dinner, you know, from starters to dessert. I mean, everything is served in a thali. The beauty of this is everything is served at once, so it looks like a very colorful palette, you know, food palette.
It's a design on a plate.
It's a design,
and it's art.
And the way it is served, you know, it makes you more hungry.
Exactly.
Food is one thing for which people do not come to the restaurant, because by any chance they can have food on the roadside larries or their home or anywhere.
Absolutely.
But when they go to a nice traditional restaurant, they want to have a complete experience.
Very true.
Right from warm welcome to food to hygiene to music to attire.
So guys, the last offering of the evening has come. और ये खिचड़ी जो बोलते हैं उसको गुजराती में बोलते हैं बघारेली खिचड़ी आ गई है. एंड कड़ी के साथ में खाई जाती है. एंड इट इज़ लाइक यू नो इट इज़ वेरी सॉफ्ट इन फ्लेवर.
जैसे अब्राहम ने कहा, ये एक क्वाइट एसेंशियल गुजराती चीज़ है जो टेस्ट बोली है. द थिंग इज बट यहाँ पे आते तो आपके दो ऑप्शन है, एक है गुजराती थाली, दूसरा है काठियावाड़ी थाली. अगर आपको माइल्ड फ्लेवर्स पसंद है तो गुजराती थाली ऑप्ट कीजिए, अगर आपको स्पाइसी फ्लेवर्स पसंद है तो काठियावाड़ी. फॉर पीपल हु हैव गॉट थिंग्स, दे प्रेफर थिंग्स विद नो ऑनियन, नो प्याज, नो प्याज, नो लहसुन, नो ऑनियन, नो गार्लिक काइंड ऑफ फूड, फॉर देम द गुजराती थाली is perfect. If you like it on the spicy side with onions and garlic and ginger, then the Kathiawadi thali is what you would prefer on your palate. Now today what we have had is a Gujarati thali, and so we're going to end this with khichdi, and then we'll go finish the palate with the leftover sweets that we have, the basundi and the halwa. Okay, I'm going to serve myself some. Help yourself.
Yeah, I'll just serve. It is garnished with coriander.
Exactly.
And the thing is, this is served with a lot of ghee, so having it with good, nice quality ghee,
it enhances the taste.
Enhances, uplifts the whole experience.
Yep. Khichdi and kadhi is like the Jai and Viru of Gujarati thali.
Exactly.
So guys, we have one more gentleman, Mr. Srinivas, who has joined us.
Ram Srinivas is also from the food industry, and he is also connected to Gopi, where he started his training, and now he has his own venture. So this is the beauty of dining at Gopi. You meet people, you meet friends, and the lovely thing about this thing is all of us are eating Gujarati thali. So here is a fellow, all the three of us are in a way Ahmedabad, but not really Ahmedabad. A genetic configuration, I am a Malayali, he's a person from Odisha. Abraham is obviously legendary, yeah. Ahmedabadi, Jewish.
Somebody who's from Maharashtra, somebody whose ancestors are from Maharashtra, came down to Ahmedabad. But now, of course, I mean, after having Gujarati thali, I just want to be called a Gojju. So guys, now I can hardly move. I mean, I'm absolutely full. But you can see from the smile of my face that I'm absolutely satisfied with all the great food that we had, all the great tastes that we tasted in this Gujarati thali by Gopi. I mean, it was absolutely fantastic, and we've come to the fag end. So, Oman, you want to say something to that?
Well, like I said, Gopi is an experience. If you're in Ahmedabad, Gopi is a place to visit on your list. If you're visiting Ahmedabad, it is definitely a place to visit on your list.
Absolutely.
It is as good as any tourist destination. Gopi is a destination.
Absolutely. So guys, if you're in Ahmedabad and if you're craving a Gujarati thali, Gopi is the place to be. Come here at Gopi Pralad Nagar and have and enjoy the great Gujarati thali. Fantastic. Let's do cheers to that.
Cheers to that.
Cheers.